Tarasenko was taken down. Puck moved up the board, stepping up Delzato with a hit.
Carkner went after Boyle.
Oh, they're going
at gloves.
They're going at it along the board.
Now Carkner went right after him. It had nothing to do with the play. It had everything to do with Boyle going out, getting some punches in on Carlson
in game number one.
That's
correct.
That's exactly what this is about. Carkner is a left defenseman that ended up over on the right side.
And Bickle.
He hit Boyle. You see Bickle trying to get in there,
He's going with Greening right now.
He had his gloves dropped, did Carkner, and started throwing punches. I think before Boyle knew he was in a fight, even though I'm sure that there were probably some words spoken.
The referees are Stephen Walcombe and Ian Walsh.
You can see Boyle still has his gloves on. Carkner's still trying to get at him. This is going to be interesting to see what the call is going to be, because Carkner was the aggressor and threw down his gloves and started throwing punches, or at least threw down one glove and started throwing punches. And you clearly saw Boyle still had his gloves and on his hands.
Boyle and Zach Smith having some words. Well, you're right. Carkner had one intent, and one intent only, and that was retaliation on Brian Boyle for what happened between Boyle and Carlson in game one.
That's right. There's Boyle with the hit. And there's Carkner. He comes all the way over, and right away, there you see the punches being thrown. And while he's down, he's still throwing punches. I mean, this is the Rangers have to end up with an awful long power play on this. Carkner should get 5 minutes for fighting. I'm not sure Boyle's going to get anything, to tell you the truth, unless something happened after that. But the Rangers, if they don't end up with a long power play on this, something's wrong. And there's Carlson, who was the recipient of some Boyle punches in game number one. And so Paul McLean wants to send a message early in this series. There's Paul, that you're not going to take that type of advantage against some of the other players. Dubinsky jumped in.
Dubinsky.
But clearly the Rangers have to end up on the power play.
All four officials have gathered together.
Okay, there's a referee watching this. One, two, three, four, five. At least five punches were being thrown while he was down on the ice, and there were a couple thrown before that. And again, he's the left defenseman. And if you're playing the game properly, if your partner is the right defense, he's over on the right side, you stay in the middle of the ice, you stay in front of the net. But he had one thing in mind, as you mentioned, to go after Brian Boyle. And Brian Boyle, at least at this point, is not getting penalized.
Yeah, it seems no worse for wear anyway. Now they're waiting for the officials to sort it all out. Dubinsky's still having words with somebody.
Who's that? Is that Kanapka? Oh, that is Carkner that's in the penalty box. Okay.
Can they hear each other through the
Yes, they can.
There? Okay.
Yes, they can. Yes, they can.
That's the linesman.
Yeah, he's gonna get I bet you Dubinsky gets thrown out.
As a third man in,
but here's what's wrong with that, is that he's going to get a game misconduct, I think.
He's got to control himself. This is
what I'm seeing, that he's going to get a game misconduct for being the third man in into an altercation. Well, there was only one player that was in the altercation. It wasn't two. See, I don't think Boyle's getting penalized on the play. So he went into
But no matter what, Joe, he can't get involved. He can't.
Well,
that's the rule.
Well,
it may not be a fair rule, but that's the rule.
So Carkner
is going to the locker room. So he may be gone for instigating, fighting, and a misconduct. Or maybe a game. We'll
wait.
See. But he's definitely getting plenty of time. Dubinsky could be gone for a game misconduct as a third man in.
If it is, he's getting thrown out, I think, just by his reaction.
Yeah.
But to me, an altercation is when two players are willing to get involved, whether it's pushing, shoving, each throw a punch. It doesn't have to be fighting. It's an altercation. This was clearly an attack by one player, and this is one player that's got to go in and help his other players just get involved. I don't like the call.
2 minutes for roughing, 5 minutes for fighting, 10 minutes misconduct, and a game misconduct.
All right, so
for the Rangers, number Carkner's 17, gone. Brandon Dubinsky, 2 minutes for roughing and a game misconduct. Time of all penalties, 2:15.
All right, so Carkner gets two for instigating, five for fighting, 10-minute misconduct,
that's
game
Carkner
misconduct. He's
Ottawa,
gone.
Two for roughing, two for fighting, a 10-minute misconduct, and a game misconduct for the Rangers, Dubinsky. 2 minutes for roughing and a game
misconduct. Here's the reason
misconduct.
All this Time started. We go back to game
2:15.
One. And there's Boyle, who pushes Carlson. Carlson pushes back, but then there's Boyle.
That's game one.
That's game one. And so that was talked about in the off days. And then here's tonight. Carkner comes all the way across, and no question, he was just going after Boyle. And Dubinsky sees this, and all he's doing, he's got to get in there and help his guy. I mean, Sam, this was a one-way altercation, if you want to call it that way. And I don't like the call. Because you've got somebody that's totally defenseless, that's not even involved, that was attacked on the play. By no means did Brian Boyle turn, look, and even have a chance to get involved in the play. He doesn't even get penalized.
But
Boyle doesn't get penalized.
Dubinsky can't join it, and that's the rule.
Well,
and he has to. The game.
Again, I
as a teammate, he does.